Shalom and welcome to this week's edition of Treasures of the Torah. I'm Pastor Matt McEwen, and this week our Torah portion is Tetzaveh. Now in this verse, verse 30 of chapter 28 in our Torah portion, we read something curious. And you shall put in the breastplate of judgment the Urim and the Tumim. Now people often wonder what these stones are that go inside the breastplate that would help the high priest make decisions for Israel. It's a very curious thing. It's something that's strange to us. But something comes to us from Rashi and in the Talmud that is really interesting and maybe something that you haven't heard before. Let me read this to us. The Urim and the Tumim, which mean the illuminator and the verifier, this was an inscription of the name of God. Inserted into the folds of the breastplate, it caused the letters inscribed on its stones to light up in response to queries posed by the community leaders, as it is written in Numbers 27:21, and Joshua shall stand before Eleazar the priest, who shall ask counsel for him after the judgment of the Urim before God. By this word shall they go out, and by this word they shall come in, both he and all of the children of Israel with him. This is why it is called the breastplate of judgment, since it decided and determined things for the people. Could you imagine that? Could you imagine asking a question of the Almighty and having an answer to that question by this very curious method of on these stones, letters actually lighting up to spell out a message of advice to you or an answer to your question? This is absolutely amazing. It sounds like something that should be in a movie. It's fascinating to us. How in the world can we make an application of that in our lives today? Now, I love the phrase that it caused the letters to light up. In fact, this Urim, we know the word or means light, and so this word Urim means illuminator. Think about that for a moment. Wouldn't it be nice if we could have the will of God, the words of God illuminated to us when we ask a question? But in a way, I say that we can. Think about this. Each week as we go through the Torah, and we go through this process every single year, but I will tell you, in my personal experience and in the experience of others that I know, even though we're reading the same Torah portions every year, every time we read them, something new is illuminated for us. What if you had a question about what to do in your life, in a certain situation, in a relationship, a decision that you had to make? What if you had something that could light up with the very words of God to tell you which way to go or which way to turn? That, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, is what the Torah does for us. It tells us where to go, where to turn, which direction to head. That is what the Torah is for us. We know that the examples that have gone on before us can lead us to where we should go. And always remember this. Everything in the Torah is an example to us. Every person in the Torah can be an example for us. Not always a good example. There are some in the Torah that when we read the holy words of this sacred writing given to us by God Himself and written down by Moses, there are times when we look at a certain individual and they are an example of what not to do. For instance, Korach's rebellion. This is an example to us, but an example in the negative sense of what not to do in our particular situation. So even though we do not have the Urim and the Tumim today, as we understand it this way, literally in the Torah itself illuminates us with answers to our questions. Thank you for joining me this week. Once again, I'm Pastor Matt McEwen. If you'd like to join our yeshiva, we'd love to invite you to do that. Please go to shuvu.tv and you can set up an interview to see if the yeshiva would be a good fit for you, if you would be a good fit for us. And just like me and many others, you can study through this discipleship program, a multi-year program, and graduate. And for some of you, which the Lord has placed a certain calling, you can even be ordained as a Torah teacher, as I have been ordained. Thank you once again for joining me. We will see you next week. Shalom.